G'day, Rookons, for the Up to Close of Trade. Thursday, the 19th of March, 2020. It's just gone 4:11 p.m. Chicago time. Do hope you are doing well. So, I'm going to start this video off by saying something I never say on my videos, which I probably should, and that is this. Do your own analysis. Don't rely on analysis you watch on videos on YouTube. That should be obvious to everybody. I don't know why today I feel the need to say that. Partly because I feel this kind of maximum contrarianness right now. I mean, I tend to be a contrarian anyway, but I feel today as if I'm kind of questioning myself. Am I an idiot and I should just, you know, think that the world is falling apart and join in with everybody else who thinks the world is falling apart, or say, no, this is, we've gone way too far. The pendulum has swung off the edge and is got to swing back. But we have got a moment of absolute peak panic kind of going on. Went through my charts at the close of today, and I don't think I've ever seen so many exhaustion patterns on better momentum. Exhaustion patterns on better momentum basically measure emotions, the extreme emotions, as they go from one side of the pendulum to the other side of the pendulum. Everybody's on one side of the boat. Everybody has rushed, you know, to one side of the boat. And when everybody's done that, you know, there's no one else left to take those positions. And so when the markets start to reverse, they reverse slowly initially, and then they speed up because people are on the wrong side of the boat. So I don't know. We've got to that place where, well, I've got to say, the people in charge, you better be right about this. You better be right. This better not be a Y2K, a WMD, kind of a moment of mass hysteria. It's like, you better be damned right about this, because you're destroying lives right now. The world economy is going down, but people are being put out of business. People's mental state is being tested. Businesses are blowing up as I'm speaking. Because, you know, the cash flow has disappeared, and the cash flow is due to disappear for some number of weeks until we decide to kind of get back to normal. Maybe, you know, we'll get an announcement in the next day or two that all of a sudden this wonder drug exists that costs nothing and works perfectly against, I'm not even going to say the name of what we're talking about, because I don't want this video to be banned on YouTube, but you know, if there's some kind of shock announcement and all of a sudden this problem kind of goes away, I mean, in the process, a lot of people's lives have been destroyed and businesses kind of gone under and so on. Anyway, I hope to God they've got it right, because otherwise they have caused a mass panic and hysteria for naught. Anyway, let us go to some charts. I'm going to go through the equities charts and the Bitcoin chart, and just show you what I'm seeing on my chart. So the first one here, this is the index S&P 500, and a little percentage change chart that I have on here. Calculates the percentage change each day, and then it accumulates the percentage down from the highs or up from the lows. And you can see we're at 29. I think a couple of days ago was about 29.6, 29.7. You know, it was just a few days ago we were talking about, well, we're down 10%. Is it going to go to 20? And then we went to 20 very easily, and now we've sliced through 20 and we're down at 30. So we're down 30%. I mean, these are the kind of levels where people kind of step back in and saying, phew, what a gift, you know. We're back down to the beginning of 2019. I mean, a lot of people running around saying depression, end of the world as we know it, blah, 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 blah. But there's also people saying, well, you know, I can buy the index at 2,300, and it was at 3,300 not so many days ago. So, is the time right for a turning? Let's look at the E-mini chart, day and night continuous contract at ES. Just my usual spiel on the right-hand side here. all everything to do with price. So this is better sine wave indicator on the price bars. Below the price bars here shows the cycle calculations in all three different time frames. The thickest lines here are the highest time frames. That enables me to calculate support and resistance lines on the price bars themselves, and that's what we have here. And then uptrends and strength is painted in red, and weakness and downtrends painted in white. On the left-hand side, we have everything to do with volume. On the bottom here, we have better momentum, showing us the buying and selling momentum. And then average trade size gives us a calculation for the professionals and amateurs. Professionals painted in blue, amateurs painted in yellow. Underneath that, we've got a combined trend indicator using both the volume and price signals. Red is strength and uptrends, and gray is weakness and downtrends. So we've got our exhaustion patterns here on better momentum kind of gone in. And at some point, we will have, I've been talking about a cyclical cross on this intermediate time frame. We slice through the support on the lowest time frame, came in, we slice through that into weakness and downtrend, but we could easily be caught by a cyclical support coming in on this intermediate time frames. And I've said in previous videos, if you look at different indices, this is the S&P 500, but if you look at the Russell, at the Dow, at the NASDAQ, this turning point is coming at different times. I mean, they're all very close together, but some of them have actually crossed and turned, not printed supports quite yet, but we're in due for some kind of support on this intermediate time frame. And just, you know, we're sitting on 30% down exhaustion sells at this point. 2300 seems to be an area where we do find a little bit. So 2262 was the low of yesterday overnight. So again, narrowing down, where do we find that kind of support kind of coming in from, which we'll have a bounce. We go through the time frames, and I'll show you what I'm doing from the lowest time frame, the 15-minute chart, then the 45, then the 135. So the 15-minute chart here, I was saying I'm looking for exhaustion sell on the downside. We have not got that, something to mirror the exhaustion buys that we had up at the highs here. So we have not had that yet. That's one signal that would be nice, but that's only one of the three. The second one is, yes, we definitely have some blue professional bars that have come in here and caused a flip in our trailing stop based on professional bars. So we're testing back down the low of those blue professional bars kind of down here. What are we talking about? 2315, something like that, 2300. The low of that kind of sequence is really important. So these blue professional bars kind of were buying it up there. So we might be testing into those lows, but we've had a little bit of strength. We broke above resistance on the lowest time frame. We were caught by resistance on the intermediate time frame. We've turned around from there. And so we're putting in on this intermediate time frame, the pullback to end of trend. But it gives us a target, a price point above which, if we start to break, things will get interesting. And so the high of this is 2457. So around the 2460, 2470, that kind of level. If we start breaking above there, that means this is a confirmed uptrend. And we could easily have found an intermediate bottom for the time being. So I'm bearing that in mind on my 15-minute chart as we kind of go forward. So we've got a little bit of strength kind of printed here, but we need confirmation. We need the prices to really break above that little sequence of red bars. And we haven't had the exhaustion sell. Maybe we'll come back later and get it. Maybe we'll get it tomorrow. Who knows? But that's what I'm looking at least on my charts. And so that pullback level on the 15, on the intermediate time frame of the 15-minute chart is a pullback level there on the lowest time frame of this chart here. So on here on the 45-minute chart, no, we've not had exhaustion sell on the way down here. We've just printed that first little pullback to end of trend that we're going to put in here. That could easily be an area of a left shoulder. But as I said, looking for three kind of indicators to come together: blue professional bars, exhaustion patterns, and price patterns. On this 45-minute chart, we've not broken above a resistance yet. We've not put an exhaustion sell. We've not got blue professional bars. So all we have is on the 15-minute chart starting to find some areas here. So the 45, not yet. And then when you go back up to the 135-minute chart, the next time frame up, you know, we're below supports here on the lowest and the intermediate time frame. We got to go put in pullback end of trends, proper pullback end of trends. So there'll be testing of this kind of move. But I'm just worried about maybe a shock kind of going the other way, because we have all these exhaustion patterns on a whole bunch of different charts. It could be violent as we get a first blush of short covering or something like that on this market. So just thinking about that. What is it? Today's Thursday, tomorrow's Friday. I think it's quad witching or something like that tomorrow. So there'll be all kinds of shenanigans in the market kind of going on, but just bear that in mind. So that's on the equities kind of side of things. On the Bitcoin side of things, we talked about the 5,900 level a couple of days ago. So similar to that pattern on the 15-minute chart, you know, we're looking for those confirmed breaks. And we had some strength after we've overshot kind of support on the 5,000 tip bar chart of Bitcoin, but never got confirmed. We never broke above that little pivot there. We never kind of got this thing going. So we got to go hunt the next level down. And that's when I put out this video here, just before we were talking about the 5,009 level here. And I'm saying we've got all this strength going on. We've got a break, kind of confirmed break above 5,009. Well, we actually got a close above 5,009, but the very first bar, it just reversed and went the other way. And we went down and tested the lows, and we put an exhaustion pattern kind of down here. So that's their exhaustion sell going on. Blue professional bars kind of coming at the lows here. This whole sequence was a very important, big ranging kind of bar there, as someone was very anxious to kind of buy it. We played that range top to bottom, and then we put an exhaustion sell. And now we've come back and we busted through the highs of that there. So here we go. Another bit of strength kind of goes in here. So we're looking at the highs of this kind of region. And then when that's 5,005 or whatever, get busted kind of convincingly. Yep, we're on our way. So we're on our way for the time being. But bear in mind, you know, all we've done on this 5,000 tip bar chart is rally from an oversold kind of position. At some point, we'll find resistance on this highest time frame when these two thick lines kind of cross. So we're going to have another kind of look down at Bitcoin, I would have thought, as a pullback to end of trend move on that highest time frame. But yeah, we got a little bit of distance to run. We've got to put in some pullback to end of trends before that kind of comes in. So anyway, Bitcoin is looking good. And just watch out over the next day or two, because we got all these exhaustion sells going on a whole bunch of markets. Kind of kicking myself that I came out of my short Aussie, short copper, short cotton positions way too early. There was more to be had, but that's me. I tend to take profits way too early. Long dollar at the moment, that's going well for me. And I'm trying to hold that to an exhaustion buy pattern and see where that kind of goes. Anyway, hope your trading is going well, and looking forward to Friday.